Hey guys, Michael here again from FCP Euro. Thank you for joining me once again in my backyard while we do this, continue this trend of DIYs at home. Today I'm going to talk to you guys a little bit about what it takes to do a brake fluid flush on your car. Again, we're going to be working on the 87 E30 in the background. And basically the steps are going to be the same on almost every vehicle. The location of things might change a little bit. The size of your brake bleeder valve might change a little bit. But other than that, the idea is going to be the same. Today we're going to be working with a motive bleeder and a catch can, as well as using our Lucamoli .4 brake fluid. This is going to be applicable to any vehicle that takes .4. It's got a boiling point of 260 degrees Celsius, a wet boiling point of 155. So pretty good, pretty standard for what we're going to be using it for. Again, I'm not tracking this car, literally just weekend driving it when I have the chance. So this is going to be more than adequate. I got myself four of these 500 milliliter bottles. This is going to be enough to do the whole vehicle. This catch can is great because it keeps you from having to use like a water bottle or some flimsy piece of rubber hose to catch any of the old fluid coming out of the calipers. The set comes with two from Motive, as well as this pre-installed, and you can move this as you need, wire hook, so you can hook the bottle to a lug stud or a coil spring, wherever it is that you're working on, just to keep it floating so it's not tipping over or falling on the ground. And we're going to be using this Motive brake bleeder. You can find this on the site as well. This has been around for a long time in my garage, so you can see it's a little bit discolored and dirty, but it's been lasting for, I think I've had it for like about 7 years now, and still works great. Really cool tool with this is you can use this even if it's just a matter of checking if you have a leak in your system. You don't necessarily have to use it for a brake flush every time. Lastly, the tools we're going to use on this specific car are going to be a 7mm wrench. This is going to be needed to undo the brake bleeder on these calipers. As far as I know, the bleeder valves are original to the car. If someone has changed them on yours or they have been retrofitted, it is possible that the size is going to be different than what was on there from the factory. And we're going to be using a breaker bar with a 17mm socket. This is just to get the wheel off the vehicle when we jack it up in the air. So I'll give you guys a better close-up shot of where we're working with, and then we'll get set up and meet me over at the E30. Hell yeah, baby. All right, not bad. I'm going to take you along real quick while we get the car up in the air and get the wheel off. Once we get the car up in the air, we're gonna go ahead and throw a jack stand under there just to be extra safe. Whenever you guys are gonna go ahead and do this brake flush on your car, you're always gonna wanna start with the wheel furthest away from the brake master cylinder. In this case, we're gonna do the rear right of the E30 first, followed by the rear left, front right, and then lastly, front left. From there, I'm gonna go ahead and take you guys underneath the engine bay. I'm gonna show you where this guy gets attached, and then I'm gonna show you where the brake bleeder valve is located on the E30, and we'll start flushing our brake system. All right, guys, before we bring the Motive bleeder over to the engine bay, we wanna go ahead and fill it up with your fluid first. That way you're not filling it at the car and potentially making a mess. I always like to lay down a little dirty rag underneath in case you spill. Don't want to dirty a fresh rag, and you don't want to dirty your table that you're working on or spill on the floor. I'm going to go ahead and pour all four of these in now just because, one, brake fluid doesn't really keep for a long time after you open it, and two, I'm just going to make sure this whole system is flushed really well. As you guys saw up in the reservoir, the fluid is very dirty. You can buy a hydraulic coloring, if you will, fluid coloring, if you want to be able to see when your new fluid is coming out of the system. You can see there's some residual blue in this hose from using some blue dye before back in the day. But basically, once you start seeing your new dyed fluid come out, you can be rest assured that you have reached a full clean line on that side of the brake system. On this car, the fluid is so gross and grimy that I know it's going to be very easy to tell once the old brake fluid is coming out, and it's just clean fluid after that, so I'm not too worried about dyeing this. but just know it is out there. I'm sure you can find it online. All right, maybe I lied. We have about half the container full. I'm gonna start with that. If this isn't needed, I'll put it back on the shelf, but we'll start with the three 1500 milliliter containers first. If for some reason I see that we're going through it very quickly, I'll go ahead and add more. But for now, let's just do the three and see how far that gets us. All right, guys, now we're gonna go ahead and attach the motive bleeder to the reservoir. It's right here on the E30. It's gonna be located on the driver's side of the passenger. Wow, driver's side of the passenger? That's sick, dude. It's gonna be located on the driver's side of the firewall. So I'm gonna go ahead and remove my cap. I like to put a little rag under here so I can rest the cap on it without dripping brake fluid all over the place while it's off the car. Just be careful. It's got two sensors on here that show your level. If it's low, it'll trigger the light on the dash. Careful not to rip them. They're old. They've been on there a long time. I'm gonna go ahead and set that to the side right there. Now on these motive bleeders, one thing that's kind of a pain is the hose to the adapter here. It's gonna fight you a little bit while you're putting it on, so you're gonna wanna do a little dance with this guy, keep this from binding up. This adapter's gonna have a little gasket on it already, so you don't have to gorilla it on, but just make it snug so it doesn't leak. All right, that's there. Our line is kink-free. Now, you're gonna be able to see on here the PSI. I'm gonna go ahead and set up a better view for you guys to see what it looks like as you pump it up. All right, guys, now that we have our brake bleeder connected, we're gonna go ahead and pressurize the system. Simply take your pump here, free it up, and we're gonna pump it up till we see about 15 PSI. All right, so this one shot it over just a little past 15. We're about the 17 PSI mark. That's all right. See that right there? So now what you're gonna wanna do is monitor that closely. I'm gonna give it about, let's say 5 minutes. If it doesn't drop, then we know the system's secure, there's no leak. I haven't had any leaks on this before I took the calipers off, so I'm gonna check where I removed the brake line during the brake job, make sure that that's on there tightly and that it's not gonna be leaking. Come back in 5 minutes and we'll see what this looks like, guys.
5 minutes later.
It's been about 5 minutes. Needle hasn't moved one bit on the gauge, so we know the system's good and secure. Now I'm gonna go ahead and let that be. While you're releasing the brake pressure per each caliper and flushing out the old fluid, you wanna make sure this doesn't drop too low. I'm gonna keep it around the 15 PSI mark. If it drops below 15, I'll bring it back up as we're siphoning out the fluid, but just keep an eye on that. You never want it to drop to zero, otherwise it's, you're defeating the purpose of this whole one-man brake flush without adding more air into the system. Now, what we're gonna wanna go ahead and do is get this little protectant cap off of your bleeder valve, push it to the side. If you have a brake sensor on this wheel, go ahead and put that over to the side as well. So our bleeder is going to be right here. I'm going to go ahead and take a wheel lug and thread it into place. I'm going to use this as my holder for my catch can. Now for this car, it's going to be a 7mm wrench to get that bleeder off. So what I'm going to do is use the closed end so I don't risk stripping it. Set that into place first. And then I'm gonna go ahead and put my catch can, little silicone receiving boot, and on that. So you're gonna look something like this. Now you're gonna wanna go ahead and break this free carefully without breaking the bleeder valve. And there she comes. Now while that's doing its thing on this side of the car, we're gonna go back to our motive bleeder and just make sure that we're not losing too much pressure on that end. So we've gone down about a PSI. We still have plenty of pressure on the system, so we're not gonna go ahead and touch it just yet. We'll keep an eye on it though, see how full that bottle gets, and from there, we'll add more pressure as need be. All right, guys, as you can see, the fluid in the line has cleared up a ton. It's no longer that dark brown murky color that we were seeing originally. And you can tell how much has come out by checking your level on your bottle. I mean, look at that. That looks like engine oil, to be quite honest, from this point of view. So I'm going to go ahead and button up the bleeder valve on this side. Still have my wrench on here. Simply going to go ahead and tighten it. Should go no more than what it came off originally. You just want to snug that back on. Doesn't need to be extremely tight, but you don't want to leave it loose either. And now that that's off, I'm going to go ahead and grab a little towel. So when I pull this off, I don't make a huge mess all over the caliper. And we should be good to go. Got my little towel. Gonna go ahead and just remove this here gently. Clear out the line. And that's what we took out. You don't have to take out this much. You can take out more if you want to. But for me, I was able to see that the line to the catch can cleared out. So that's as far as we're going to go. I always like to join the silicone end of the hose back to the same catch can so there's no error in case you knock it over. It's not going to spill on you. And from there, once you know that's secure, going to go ahead and take the wrench off. Feed our brake sensor wire back through there. Cap off our bleeder. And that's it. All right, guys. Thank you for joining me underneath the car one last time. I wasn't going to sleep well if I didn't go ahead and tackle this. And I figured I might as well show you guys since I'm going to do it anyways. Not a required step, just something that you can do if you have a manual transmission car where the slave cylinder for the transmission is also where the slave cylinder and the brakes share the same reservoir. So basically the same fluid that we just flushed out the brake lines, same dirty fluid is trapped in this clutch line. So you're going to have your slave right here. Is going to be your bleeder, just like on the brake calipers. This is still a 7mm valve, so I'm going to go ahead and hook up my silicone hose and my wrench and break it free and bleed it out for a little bit, and that should be the last piece of the puzzle to this brake flush. If you're looking for this on your car, most slave cylinders are going to be on the driver's side of the car. So I have the driver's side jacked up, got a jack stand underneath, and I just crawled in from the driver's side by the driver's door. And that should be good. Our catch can's getting pretty full. And just like so, I'm gonna go ahead and get our towel ready. I'm gonna excuse the towel, but I'm gonna remove the hose while grabbing it with the towel so any drippage falls on here and not on the floor or anything else. Wipe it down at the same time. And that is it. Super simple, guys. Having the right tools makes this super easy. I'm not fishing for used lines or empty water bottles or anything of that nature. That's snug just like it was. All right, guys. We have just completed bleeding all four corners of the car. And in addition, I went ahead and did the slave cylinder. I was going to think about it forever if I just didn't do it since I had everything set up already. So now that we're done, we still have pressure on the system. We want to go ahead and release it from here, from the motive bleeder, before we disconnect it at the reservoir. Otherwise, you'll make a huge mess. So I'm just going to go ahead and carefully grip this in a way that you won't hurt anything. You'll see the pressure drop. Bam, baby. Now, usually these are going to leave your level on the reservoir up to the full line. It doesn't always work that way. So be ready to have to, turkey baster or sop up a little bit of brake fluid if you are overfilled. I'm going to go ahead and let this thing do its thing. I'm going to take it off screen here and just drop it down let whatever I can come down and let gravity do its job. Perfect. Now that that's as much as I've gotten done, I'm going to go ahead and remove the adapter off of the reservoir, and that should conclude everything up here as far as using the motive bleeder. Got my towel ready for any spillage, because there's always bound to be spillage. Flip it over if you can as soon as you undo it. And oh wow, we didn't spill a single drop up there. Incredible. After checking the reservoir, no spillage, and shockingly we were able to get it. It's right up at to the full line, or the max line if you will, on the side of the reservoir. On my car you can see it in between the intake manifold and the reservoir itself. So that's awesome, no need to turkey baste or anything. If you remember earlier, we had taken out this little, call it a little sleeve for where the level sensor sits, but it was covered in disgusting grimy brake dust. Went ahead and cleaned that up. Gonna go ahead and put this back in, put our cap back on, and that'll conclude everything that we need to do in the car. And that does it, baby. That concludes the brake system flush on this E30 of mine. So again, just to recap real quick, we went ahead, we got the car up on the air. We filled this guy with 1,500 milliliters of liquid moly .4 brake fluid. As you can see, we all used maybe half of what was in here. So again, like I said, it was overkill. I wanted to make sure I got everything out of the system. And again, you can't really store brake fluid for too long after you've opened it. Moisture builds up and it's just, you know, if you're gonna use it, use it. It's always better to have extra than not enough. So we did the rear right, rear left, front right, and then front left wheel. And then for my peace of mind, I went ahead and did the slave cylinder. It's all part of the same system on this car, so I'm gonna sleep better knowing that I did it now. So you can see how much fluid we have left. I'm gonna push this to the side and I'm gonna show you guys the muck that came out of this car. Again, I don't know when the last time the brakes were bled. Since I've owned this car for just coming up on 2 years now, this is my first opportunity at being able to do them. So I push that to the side. We have our empty liquid moly container right here. I'm gonna take this and recycle it. Look at the color of this. You can compare the color of the stuff in the reservoir versus the motive bleeder, versus the color of the stuff in this catch can. I mean, honestly, this almost looks like engine oil. It's so disgusting. Put that over there and take off our cap carefully. Make sure not to take a bath in this. I do have to shower, but I don't want to shower in brake fluid. I'm gonna remove this. Let that drip a little bit there. Again, always try to have a towel underneath so you don't make a mess on whatever surface you're working on. For me, when I'm done with this, I'm gonna go ahead and brake clean this container out. I don't like putting stuff away dirty in case I need to use it again. But look at this. Disgusting. We have another empty container. I'm gonna grab a second one just to play it safe. No need to fill this one to the brim. We got plenty of extras. Oh, here comes the good stuff. Oh yeah, you can see the dirt in this fluid. That's disgusting. I don't know if you can see this, guys, but check this out. This is a brand new catch can before we started. Look at all that muck in there. Who knows how long that was in there for. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions or comments, please be sure to drop those below. Give the video a thumbs up if you like what you saw. And more importantly, subscribe. We're gonna be doing a couple of these DIYs. A couple of us from home are gonna be setting up and showing you guys a couple of cool projects that you can do in your own driveway, just like we do here. If there's anything that you wanna see specifically, or maybe we missed something, or there's something that you'd like to see covered, please leave that in the comment section below as well. We'll be happy to try and tackle that for you. Thank you again for watching, guys. Please stay safe, and more importantly, stay 6 feet apart.